Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chansom. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Tuesday, the 15th of September. Border issue with China remains unresolved, says India's Defence Minister. Pakistan's Prime Minister Imran Khan calls for chemical castration of rapist. And Bangladesh economy shows early signs of recovery amid pandemic. And now for all the details. India's Defence Minister Rajnath Singh on Tuesday said in the Parliament that the India-China border row remains unresolved and that China is not honouring the customary alignment of the boundary with India. Terming the issue a complex one, Singh said that both countries have, however, agreed to resolve it peacefully.
India's Defence Minister Rajnath Singh on Tuesday said that China is not honouring the customary alignment of the boundary with India and the border row remains unresolved. While addressing the Parliament on the border standoff with China in Ladakh on the second day of the monsoon session, Singh said that the alignment has not only been defined by treaties but has been maintained historically. However, China believes that the border is not defined. Terming the issue a complex one, Singh said that both countries have mutually agreed that maintaining peace and tranquility on the border are essential for further development of bilateral ties.
...ki sthiti, chahe wo troops ki scale of involvement ho, ya friction points ki sankhya ho, wo pehle se bahut alag hai. Phir bhi hum, maujuda sthiti ke shantipur samadhan ke liye puri tarah se committed hai. इसके साथ साथ मैं सदन को आश्वस्त करना चाहता हूं कि हम सभी परिस्थितियों से निपटने के लिए भी तैयार हैं।
The Defence Minister's statement comes amid repeated transgressions by the Chinese troops at Pangong Lake and several other areas in Ladakh since April. On June 15, 20 Indian soldiers were killed in a violent standoff with Chinese troops in Ladakh's Galwan Valley. In a high-level meeting between foreign ministers of India and China in Moscow this month, the South Asian giants had agreed to de-escalate their tensions.
An encounter broke out between security forces and terrorists in Pulwama district of India's northern Jammu and Kashmir territory on Tuesday, police said. Acting on specific information about the presence of terrorists in Marwal area of Pulwama, security forces launched a cordon and search operation there. The operation of the security forces was underway till the last reports came in. Meanwhile, in a separate operation, the police arrested two militant associates of the Al-Badra outfit in South Kashmir's Avantipura. Late last month, Islamist militant outfit Al-Badra's founder Sakur Ahmed Peri, among seven other militants, were killed in two separate encounters in Pulwama and Shopian districts. One of the neutralized militants had abducted and killed a village head in Kashmir Valley. In news from Pakistan, Pakistan's Prime Minister Imran Khan has called for chemical castration of rapists as authorities are still carrying out operations to nab the main culprit of the rape of a woman in a popular highway in Lahore city last week. Police had arrested a co-suspect in the rape case on Monday.
Pakistan's Prime Minister Imran Khan on Monday said he wanted convicted rapists to be chemically castrated, reacting to a question on the rape of a woman last week that has caused uproar in the South Asian nation. A mother of two driving along a major highway near Lahore city was dragged out of her car and raped by two men at gunpoint. Police arrested a suspect on Monday. Khan said he believed the culprit should be hanged publicly but added that officials had informed him that such an act could endanger a preferential trade status given to Pakistan by the European Union or EU. However, the Prime Minister said he was also looking into the option of chemical castration instead.
जिस तरह मर्डर होता है फर्स्ट डिग्री, सेकंड डिग्री, थर्ड डिग्री, उसी तरह इसको भी ग्रेड करें, और जो फर्स्ट डिग्री हो उसको तो कैस्ट्रेशन करें, यानी उनको कभी भी, यानी उनको आप ऑपरेशन करके उनको नकारा करके रख दें।
Khan's remark came as Pakistani officials announced that one of the two main suspects had been arrested and had admitted the crime. Officials said they also had a positive DNA match and search for the main culprit is still going on. The assault sparked nationwide protest and calls for the resignation of officials as well as the public hanging of rapist.
Moving on, with picturesque landscape and cultural diversity, Gilgit-Baltistan is the ultimate tourist destination. However, the decades-long illegal occupation by the Pakistan government has brought the entire region to the brink. Locals blame Islamabad's unwillingness to develop the tourism sector as the reason for its downfall.
The remote Himalayan region of Gilgit-Baltistan is blessed with breathtaking beauty. However, locals blame Islamabad's indifference in developing the tourism sector of the illegally occupied region has made it out of bounds for the tourists. The Gizar district of Gilgit-Baltistan is home to diverse flora and fauna and features stunning valleys and crystal blue lakes. But the lack of infrastructure, including road accessibility, mobile network and transport facilities, serve as major hindrances for even the domestic tourists who were left disappointed.
ये कुदरती नज़ारे अगर आप देखें, लैंडस्केप्स देखें, पानी को देखें और जितनी अच्छी यहाँ पे लोगों की हॉस्पिटैलिटी है, उस हिसाब से यहाँ पे जो बेसिक नेसेसिटीज़ हैं या बेसिक जो फैसिलिटीज़ हैं वो अवेलेबल नहीं हैं। अब कोई भी टूरिस्ट आता है यहाँ पे, अगर कोई फैमिली के साथ आए तो उनको अच्छी खासी मुश्किलात होगी। मुश्किलात में दो तीन चीज़ें हैं। सबसे अहम चीज़ ये है कि आपके मीन्स ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन क्या हैं, वहाँ पे जहाँ पे आप जाते हैं वहाँ पे आपके रोड ठीक नहीं है।
Locals say with proper policies and planning by the Pakistan government, the tourism sector could have given a major boost to the economy of the illegally occupied region. However, it has remained backwards and underdeveloped due to the apathy of the federal government of Pakistan over the years.
In news from Afghanistan, families of the victims of a 2018 Kabul suicide attack gathered on Monday at the graveyard of their loved ones and called for a lasting peace as Afghan government officials and the Taliban hold talks in Doha to end the 19 years of war in the country.
Families of the victims of a 2018 suicide attack in Kabul gathered on Monday at the graveyard of their loved ones and called for a lasting peace as Afghan government officials and the Taliban hold talks in Doha to end 19 years of war in the country. At least 34 students were killed and over 50 wounded during the attack on 15th of August 2018 as students were preparing for university entrance exams in a classroom at the Mawood Academy in West Kabul. There has been no claim of responsibility and the Taliban also denied carrying it out.
As devlet is, hukumet is, bolo da soy ki, soloy sol khunish ba, khuni merdum ra khurdan, boloy gurdoy merdum savar shudan. Orzu yek sol darim, yek orami darim to, hamchin javanoy dar oinde mislimot tu chor chin mushkilat nashan.
The opening ceremony for the peace talks in Qatar's capital Doha on Saturday, replete with calls for peace and a host of dignitaries urging a ceasefire, contrasting sharply with the recent violence on the ground in Afghanistan's Kunduz province. According to reports, Afghan government and the Taliban peace talk negotiators were expected to hold their first direct session on Tuesday in Doha.
Let's move on to news from Bangladesh. The pandemic has taken a toll on economies around the world. Bangladesh has been confronting a twin crisis of extreme weather disasters and a pandemic that's killed thousands so far. The Asian Development Bank, in its latest report, has said that Bangladesh's economy has started recovering from the pandemic. The Asian Development Bank, in its latest report, Asian Development Outlook 2020, released on Tuesday, said that Bangladesh's economy has started recovering from the pandemic. The Bangladesh economy is showing early signs of recovery, with gross domestic product or GDP expected to grow at 6.8% in the fiscal year 2021. Inflation is expected to moderate to 5.5% and current account deficit is likely to narrow to 1.1% of GDP in financial year 2021. The report pointed out that prudent macroeconomic management and speedy implementation of the government stimulus measures are key imperatives to ensure the projected recovery. It cautioned that the main risk to this growth projection is a prolonged pandemic in Bangladesh or its export destinations. ADB Country Director Manmohan Prakash said that recent economic performance in exports and remittances and government's macroeconomic management, including securing foreign funds for economic stimulus and social protection measures, have made this recovery feasible. ADB has provided an initial assistance of $600 million in loans and $4.4 million in grants for managing socio-economic impacts of COVID-19 pandemic and supporting quick recovery. Moving on, Sri Lanka has started a repair work on the ruptured fuel oil tank in the engine room of a striking fully loaded oil supertanker after plugging the leak. Fire broke out in the engine room of the Greek-owned New Diamond on 3rd of September. The ship had left long trails of marine oil slicks. Sri Lanka has started repair work on the ruptured fuel oil tank in the engine room of a striking fully loaded oil supertanker after plugging the leak, the country's navy said on Monday. The supertanker is 52 nautical miles, that is 96 kilometers, from the Sri Lankan coast, Navy spokesman Indika De Silva said. Fire broke out in the engine room of the Greek-owned New Diamond on September 3. The ship had left long trails of marine oil slicks. The Sri Lankan Navy and Indian Coast Guard divers on Sunday inspected the vessels and surrounding areas for any further leak. A team of officials from Sri Lanka's Marine Environment Protection Authorities or MEPA visited the tanker on Monday to inspect and collect samples of marine fuel oil from the vessel loaded with about 2 million barrels of oil. The authorities said it plans to take action against the ship's owner under the country's law protecting the marine ecosystem. Realizing the potential of a non-traditional cash crop like mushroom, locals in Northeast India are shifting their attention towards mushroom cultivation. Dr. Sosang Longkumar, who runs a bio lab in Nagaland state, is creating opportunities for those who are interested in mushroom cultivation by educating them about the field and the technical support needed for it.
Climatic conditions in India's northeastern region are favorable for natural occurrence of mushrooms, and those realizing the potential of this non-traditional cash crop are shifting their attention towards mushroom cultivation. Dr. Sosang Longkumar, a PhD in microbiology and genetics, runs a bio lab in India's northeastern Nagaland state, creating opportunities for those who are interested in mushroom cultivation. Longkumar, who himself took a loan to run his bio lab and produce mushroom swans, educates locals about mushroom cultivation and technical support needed in the field.
I give the swan and I give the training to only those people in terms and conditions. Terms and condition is that they will cut only the tree branches, not the tree. So if they cut the tree, I inspect that, and if they cut the tree, then I don't give them the seeds. They have to cut the branches.
Mushroom farmers in Nagaland mostly cultivate oyster mushrooms. However, many farmers are now also adopting another variety called shiitake mushroom in the colder districts of the state.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/asianewsline and follow us on Twitter at asianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.